Have you wondered how to use the zoom function as you see right here? Or have you even wondered how to maybe link things in your PowerPoint presentation? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to use everything within the links section in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so if I go into the links section, you're going to see right up here that we have three options: zoom, link, and action. So link and action are actually grayed out right now because you need to have something selected in order for those actions to take place. So let's start with the zoom section in PowerPoint. So if I go up here to home and then I go to insert, and then I go all the way here to links and click on zoom, I'm going to then see three options: summary zoom, section zoom, and slide zoom. Now all three of these differ slightly, but I'm going to show you guys what each one does and how they're slightly different. So let's start off with summary zoom. All right, so I'm going to click on this, and now what this allows me to do is it almost acts like an index page. So it's going to create a new section and a new slide, and it's going to include all the slides that I want to include on that slide. It's almost like an index for people to jump into that section to learn more about that part of the presentation. All right, so I'm going to select this map slide right here, uncheck mark this, uncheck mark these, keep these five country slides in, and so now I'll have six slides total that I'll have included in this summary section. So I'm going to insert them now. All right, so now they're inserted on the screen, and now a new section called summary section was created. All right, so now if I go into presentation mode and I just click on this one right here, and then I click again, it's going to take me to the next slide within that section of that map section. So slide one, slide two, and slide three. All right, and then it's going to bring me back to the summary section slide once I'm done with that section. So this is just a quick way if you want people to jump to certain sections of your PowerPoint presentation and then bring you back to that index page. All right, so next one I want to show you guys is how to use the section zoom. So if I click on this, it's very similar to summary zoom, but what's different about section zoom is that you can just pick a couple of sections. So let's say I just want to pick this section and this one right here. Insert them. It's not going to be as organized, and it's also not going to create a new section called summary section. It's just going to insert them on your current slide, and it's just going to be what it is. And you can move these around and adjust the sizing of them, and then you can go into presentation mode. You could click on this right here, and then you can go through all your slides in that section, and then maybe go to the next one, and then zoom back out. So it's fairly similar to the previous option. It's just not as organized and clean, and it doesn't create a new section for you like an index page. You just have the ability to insert them right on that actual slide that you're working on. All right, so now for the last option, which is slide zoom. So slide zoom is a little different than section zoom. Just think of it as going to the exact slide and not the section. So if I click on slide zoom, I then can click on this slide, and this slide, insert, and I can space them out like so. So, and then go into presentation mode. And now if I click, it's going to take me to this slide. And then if I click again, it's going to go to the next slide. And then if I click again, it's going to go to slide two. Now keep in mind, if let's say you do have slides that are in between slide one and slide two, it's going to go through the rest of your slides before it gets to that slide two. Let's say add a bunch of slides in between here, like so. And then I went back here and went into presentation mode. Watch this. I'll click. It'll jump, go to slide one, but now it's going to go through those slides and then get to slide two. And then it kind of just goes through your entire presentation. So I really would only use the slide zoom feature if your slides are back to back, because then it does that cool feature where it'll zoom out and then move over to the next slide. All right, so the next feature I want to show you guys with zoom is how to actually use it for what most people like to use it for. So let's say you have a picture like this of a country, but you want to have the ability to zoom into a certain section of that picture. Well, this is how you can do it. So let's say you have the United States, Brazil, Russia, China, and Australia. You have all these slides created, and you want to zoom into different sections of this map based on what country you're talking about. So you click and drag slide two, drag it onto this slide, and then do the same for slide three, do the same for slide four, do the same for slide five, and do the same for slide six. Now you got to be careful with this, because let's say you're trying to do this, and a lot of people will make this mistake, is you're trying to drag this slide onto here. They're on this slide right now. They click on this, and now they're on slide two. You don't want to click and release. What you want to do is make sure you're selected slide one, click slide two, click and hold, don't let go, and then drag it over and drop. So that is how you can easily drag and drop those sections on. All right, so now I'm just gonna put these in where they need to be. So I'm just gonna put this right here and then put this kind of right, we'll put it right here. And then we'll put China kind of right here and Australia right here. Now, I apologize in advance if I kind of got the exact locations wrong, but I'm just trying to eyeball it at the moment. Now, as you can see here, this does not look the most appealing. We have a black background and we don't want to have the background included in this visual. So here's what we can do. We go up here to format, and then if we have this selected, what we can do is we can actually get rid of the zoom background. So if we click zoom background, and then we'll get rid of the zoom background for you, so that's just the text on your slide, or if there's icons or whatever it may be, it'll get rid of that, so it's just transparent and you have your text. So now what I can do is I can do that for the rest of these and select zoom background to get rid of them. All right, and now what I'll probably do is just decrease the size of these a bit. So I'm just gonna select all of them, hit Control Shift, click the right corner, and this will decrease the size of them. And now they kind of fit a little bit better in each and one of these countries. All right, so now what we have is a zoom effect. So if we go into this presentation, it's gonna pop up this world map. But now if I hit the right arrow, or if I even click, it's gonna zoom in to that first slide I dragged onto my presentation. So it's gonna zoom into the United States, then I'll zoom into Brazil, then I'll zoom into Russia, and then China, and then Australia. So this is just a nice and quick tutorial on how to easily zoom into different parts of this map to show people visually on what country you might be talking about. And this is just a simple use case. You can use this for other use cases other than using a map. If I went back here and clicked on this, go to format, let's say I want to return to zoom instead of going from one to the next. I can hit this return to zoom, and then I'll hit this for this one as well, and this one, and this one. Now let's go into presentation mode and show you guys what this does. So if I go here, click, it's going to zoom in the United States just like before. But then if I click again, it's going to zoom back out. And then if I click one more time, it's going to zoom back in. So there's a couple different options here on what you can do with the zoom effect. If you want to just stay zoom in and then have it go from one location to the next on the screen, you can do that. Or if you want to go back to the original map and then zoom back in, that is also a feature. All right. So then if I go back here to format, you have a bunch of different options here for you. So you have zoom transition. So if I uncheck this, this is what will happen. I'll uncheck it for this one here just to show you guys quickly as to what this can do. Go into presentation mode, hit the right arrow. It just goes straight to that section. It doesn't have a nice zoom effect, just straight to it. Hit again, bam, it's just straight to it. So I normally like to just have it smoothly zoom in because I feel like that's the whole point of using the zoom feature. If you really wanted to just have it like immediately show that zoom section, you can, but I would just create a slide then and just make a lot simpler if you were to go that route. All right, so let's say you did like all these names here, but you weren't the biggest fan of it and you don't want to go through all the work of changing all these slides. What you can do is go here to change image, and then you can pick here. Let's say you want to pick from file, online pictures, or even icons. You can pick an icon, and then let's just say I want to do this analytics chart right here. Insert it in. And now it's going to change that visual to be the analytics icon. Not sure why you'd use this functionality. I mean, you can if you want, but I would honestly probably change it on the slide. You can do this as a shortcut, but it might get a little confusing on how the whole zoom feature works. So just be mindful of that if you are trying to use this change image functionality. Next, what we have is different zoom effects. So feel free to play around with that, and zoom border. So if you do have a border on your slide, you can always say no outline, or if you go here and do no outline, you can do that. Or if you do want outline, you can choose it and you could say white. And then there's a bunch of other formatting options that you have as well with zoom. So that is just a brief overview of how to use the zoom part of the entire links section. Now let's show you guys how to use actual links and actions. So this part of the tutorial is a little bit more simpler in my opinion, just because Zoom can get a little complicated. So let's say you want to use link or action. You have to have something selected. So let's say I click on this text box right here, and now you see that these two options lit up. So let's click on link, hit the drop-down menu. Here's a couple of options. You can link to an actual physical document, and that will send that person to that document. Now, I haven't tried this out with sharing this to other people that aren't on your actual physical device, so it may not work that way, but I'm guessing it should, and it should embed that actual file for someone to have access to. But correct me if I'm wrong if you have tried it in the comments down below. Also, if you just hit the icon in general without hitting the drop-down, it'll allow you to hit existing file or web page, a place in this document, or even an email address. So a lot of times people will probably want to direct you to a certain link. So you can always type in, like, let's say you want to do Google, hit okay. And now if I go into presentation mode and I click on this, it's going to then load up Google right here. Another thing I want to show you guys with links is that you can actually create actions for your links. So let's say you click on United States and you want to create an action. So create an action. Right now it's hyperlinked to www.google.com. Obviously you can change this website if you want to change it to maybe like a slide or a URL. You can type it in here and that way it'll direct you to whatever your heart desires. So let's say I want to direct it to slide 4, Russia. What I do is I'll hit this drop down menu, hit slide, and then I'll do slide 4, and it'll have a preview of what that slide looks like just to make sure that is the slide I want to choose. Hit okay. Now if I go into presentation mode and I select this, it's going to take me to that slide called Russia. All right, so you can kind of do the same functionality if you were to just click on the links as well, and you can do place in document, hit slide 4, hit okay, and then I'll go to slide 4. But this is just another way of doing it. Another thing I also really like is that they have two options here in this action section. They have mouse click and mouse over. So if you do mouse over and hyperlink to, let's say, the next slide, we can do that. Hit okay. Go into presentation mode. Now I got my mouse here. Let's say you just have your mouse available to you while you're presenting. And the second you go over this, it's gonna take you to that next slide. So it almost acts like a website in a way, because it's automatically taking you to that next slide just when you use your mouse. So it's a pretty cool functionality if you are having the ability to use your mouse while presenting your slides. All right, so that is how to use the links section in PowerPoint. If you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I'd greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things about PowerPoint, I do have a course available on Udemy, so I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.